Since the release of the Sgt. Pepper's 50th anniversary box set in 2017, the Beatles' later career has been well represented. But there's a gap in this box set chronology, which might turn out to be the most interesting of all. I'm Andrew from Parlagram, and welcome to the Beatles' Missing Box Set. Although some might disagree, I think it's fair to say that the music the Beatles made between the period 1966 and 1969 is the most popular among audiences today. And it's one which Apple has served us well with. But there's a period within that time frame which has, up to this point, been unfairly neglected. The period I'm talking about is the one from mid-1967 to early 1968. More specifically, after the recording of Sgt. Pepper and before they travelled to India. Now, during that time, the Beatles, thanks in part to some mind-altering substances, made some of the most experimental, entertaining, and interesting recordings of their career. And I think it's high time Apple put them together as a box set. Over the years, Apple have skirted around this period, giving it only scant attention. For example, Anthology 2 gave us just a handful of tracks from this period, and most of those came from Magical Mystery Tour. Speaking of which, yes, there was a Magical Mystery Tour box set back in 2012, and here it is. But the main focus of this was on the film. The only music it contained was on this reproduction of the UK Mono EP set, which, by the way, was of decent quality. Although rich in visual content, the 2012 box here didn't give us much in the way of new standalone audio. It did, however, include the instrumental composition Shirley's Wild Accordion, but ignored the nearly 8-minute version of Flying called Aerial Tour, and another instrumental called Jess's Dream, which played as John shoveled spaghetti onto Jess's plate, together with the version of the title track featuring John's vocal as it appeared in the film, should also be included. It would be great to have pristine analog, stereo and mono mixes of all the film songs included in the set, along with all the other tracks that appeared on the Capitol album, including that early 1966 stereo mix of Strawberry Fields Forever. Or why not include this incredible German-sounding edition on vinyl as a bonus? The White Album box set also touched on this period by giving us new versions of The Inner Light, Lady Madonna and Across the Universe, which only whetted our appetites for more. But complaining about it isn't going to get us anywhere. So how about we give the folks at Apple a hand and suggest what we would like to see in such a set? Now, if you watched our video about Anthology 2, if not, there's a link in the description, we talked about some interesting tracks from the period May to September 1967, which were under consideration for that album, but ultimately failed to make the cut. That period between the end of the Sgt. Pepper sessions and the filming of Magical Mystery Tour is, I think, a fascinating one. And during that time, they laid down some crazy stuff. One of those tracks, which was up for consideration for Anthology 2, is an untitled track, recorded during an all-night session on the 9th of May, which in fact lasted from 11 p.m. to 6:15 a.m. Despite being in the studio for over 7 hours, the Beatles recorded just a single track that night. The 16-minute track was basically an out-of-tune jam comprising two guitars, drums and harmonium, which, okay, may not be for everyone, but I'd really like to hear it. The next track which was being considered was the backing for Baby You're a Rich Man, recorded at Olympic Sound Studios 2 days later on May the 11th. With its thumping bassline, this is one of the best recorded examples of Paul's Rickenbacker ever put onto tape. Although it's possible to hear the backing track yourself today using the amazing La 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 tool, it will be fascinating to hear the whole session itself. Just as intriguing was a medley recorded on May the 12th, which was most likely done as a warm-up for All Together Now. It consists of three short acoustic numbers, which, like Maggie May on Let It Be, were of the traditional variety. The songs were Hey Lily, Lily Low, Diggin' My Potatoes and Rock Island Line, which along with two takes of All Together Now were under consideration for Anthology. With George Martin away, the Beatles did play, and during their next session at Delane Lee Studios in Soho, they recorded four chaotic rhythm tracks of George's It's All Too Much. Again, these were turned down for Anthology in 1996, but highlights from this and its follow-up session on June the 2nd would be amazing to hear and would fit perfectly into this box set. By the way, there's always been a debate about what is actually said at the beginning of It's All Too Much, before the guitar kicks in. So, I decided to use the la-la-la tool to separate the voice from the instruments, and this is what I got. Now, I'd say that's interesting, but inconclusive. What do you think? Now, imperfect as it is, I love playing around with this tool, and have been trying it on other tracks too. For example, there's always been another debate about who sings the She Loves You refrain on the All You Need Is Love fade out. So, here it is in isolation. For me, I think Paul starts it and is then joined by John. Let me know what you think. Now, you can try out this tool for free, but if you want to download entire tracks, you'll need to sign up for some processing minutes. And if you use the link in the description, I'll get a little kickback, which helps to keep the channel going. And yes, it does work on mono recordings too. Anyway, back to May 1967 and one of Paul's favourite Beatles tracks. Now, George Harrison edited the master version of You Know My Name, Look Up the Number for Anthology 2. But hearing the sessions from its May the 17th recording and those from June the 7th to 9th would, given how much fun everyone had making it, be another highlight of this set. I'd even settle for a stereo mix. George Martin said that whenever the Beatles were working on a song they didn't like too much, or one that wasn't particularly good, they would say, OK, let's put that aside for Yellow Submarine. Their press officer Tony Barrow also remembers this negative attitude and remembers them saying that, quote, nothing's too good for the film, so that's what we'll give them. Nothing. Like it or not, Yellow Submarine is one of the least popular albums in the original catalogue. And I get that. However, it does contain some great tracks. It's Only a Northern Song was, before With Him Without You came along, going to be George's major contribution to Sgt. Pepper's. But the fact that it was kicked down the road shows how little the others thought of it. Sadly, It's All Too Much seems to have suffered the same fate. But both those songs would be worthy additions in this set, especially the full uncut 8-minute version of It's All Too Much, as would anything from the Hey Bulldog session from February the 11th, which was their final session before they went to India. Now, of course, I can't let this particular video go without mentioning the elephant in the room, Carnival of Light. If you know the title, you surely know the story behind this legendary unreleased track. But for those who don't, let me explain. Carnival of Light was a 13-minute, 48-second track recorded at Abbey Road on January the 5th, 1967, for two events at the Roundhouse in London. Composed by Paul, under the influence of artists like John Cage on albums like this one, it began a relationship with this style of music, which he's continued throughout his career. Carnival of Light is described as, by the few who've actually heard it, which doesn't include me, as being a bizarre collection of loops and distortions. Although recorded in one take, it was subjected to overdubs, which included organ sounds, a distorted lead guitar, the sound of a church organ, water gargling, as well as John and Paul running around screaming random phrases, such as Are You All Right? And Barcelona. A rough mono mix was handed to the event organisers, but the session tape still exists in the Abbey Road archive and was slated for inclusion on Anthology 2, but vetoed by George. Today, its release, I think, would be a huge anti-climax, and like Revolution No. 9, be a challenging listen for some, but historically, as an experimental early piece of psychedelia, it would fit perfectly into this box. As far as presentation goes, there's one format which I think could be perfect for this set. The The way people listen to music has evolved significantly since the Sgt. Pepper box was released in 2017. And it's really only been since the Let It Be set that vinyl stopped being the poor relation. CDs are now in danger of becoming a niche format. The Blu-ray disc, a highlight for so many on the earlier sets, was dropped for Revolver, indicating that its time in these sets may be over, as the industry continues to walk away from physical media. Online streaming, with its Dolby Atmos capabilities, is fast becoming the preferred way of listening to music by the masses. But us Beatles collectors are different. We love our physical product, especially vinyl. Some time ago, we made a video where we discussed what a new EP collection would look like. So why not make this a multiple EP set? After all, the Magical Mystery Tour was originally released that way, and it would be the perfect opportunity to include the cancelled Yellow Submarine EP. My friend Jeff has even done a cover for it already. But of course, I wouldn't turn my nose up at a full 12-inch set. As for a title, how about Psychedelic Beatles or maybe Carnival of Sound? Let me know what you think and which tracks you think should be on it in the comments. You never know who's listening. I really hope you enjoyed this video, which you might have noticed has been made on a different camera with a different setup. It's just an experiment, but let me know if you like it or do you prefer the old setup. I'll be back next week with one or the other. But that's all for this time, so I'll say bye for now and thanks for watching. Mm-hmm.